Hello dear students and very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Motion and measurement of distances. Okay. So in our previous video we have discussed about the some points, that is we have discussed about the story of transport and also we have discussed about the measurement. So today we'll move for the next point from the same lesson and the name of the point is what? Standard units of measurement. Okay, standard units of measurement. So as we know in the ancient time there were no different types of the standard units to use the different quantities. Okay, so how the peoples were measuring the different things? So in the ancient time the peoples were using their body parts to measure the different things or to measure the different objects or to measure the different physical quantities. Okay, so they can use the different body parts, like that we can say that they can use their hand span. Okay, they were using their hand span. Hand span means what? It is the distance of the stretched thumb to the little finger. This is what? Hand span, we can say that. Next one is that also they were using the cubit. Okay, now cubit means what? It is the distance of the arm length. So from the distance from here to here, it is called as what? Arm length. Okay, it is called as what? Elbow to fingers, it is called as what? Arm length. Next one we can say that foot or padham. Okay, foot or padham, it is means what? The length of the outstretched arm. Okay, the length of the outstretched arms is called as what? Foot or padham. So all these are the different units they were using and all these units are with the help of the different body parts. Okay, so they are different body parts, they are different body parts they were using to measure the different quantities. Okay, but these body parts the unit of these body parts were not good. Okay, or they were not fixed and reliable, because as we changed a person or person to person, the length of the body parts were different. Okay, so the why all these units were not reliable, why it is not good to measure? Because as we know, person to person the size of the body organs are getting changed, and that is the reason all these units were not reliable for the measurement. Okay, and these units cannot be used as a standard units of measurement. All these units cannot be used as a standard units of measurement, and that is the time the people realize that they need a standard units of measurement. Okay, they need a standard units of measurement. Now let's see what is mean by standard units of measurement. Standard units of measurement are those that have a fixed quantity or value, we can say that, and therefore do not vary from person to person and place to place. So what is mean by standard units? Standard units means what? The standard units of measurement are those that have a fixed quantity, means the standard units are having fixed quantity or fixed value, and that fixed quantity or that fixed value cannot be changed or they cannot be varied, do not vary from person to person or from place to place. Okay, so let's take one example. See, this is marker. I'm having this marker. Now I will measure the length of the marker with this scale. Okay, and what is the length of this marker? Here I have measured the length of the marker and it is 14 centimeter. Okay, and if the length of the marker is what? 14 centimeter. If now anyone other will count or anyone other will measure the length of this marker, then also it will come as a 14 centimeter. If you will measure at the home the length of the marker, then it will also come as a 14 centimeter only. Why? Because I have measured the length of the marker with the help of the standard unit. Okay, with the help of the standard unit of measurement, that is what we can say that length. Okay, because I have measured the length of the marker with the help of this scale. Okay, so it means what? The standard units of measurement are those that have a fixed quantity or value and therefore do not vary from person to person and place to place. Okay, and why does
necessary, why we need the standard units of measurement? The standard units of measurement is necessary
for the uniformity and for the convenience to of measurement, okay, for the convenience and the uniformity of the measurement. Okay, so let's discuss about the SI unit of physical quantities. Okay, in 1960 scientists adopted uniform and convenient common set of standard units for measurement of different physical quantities. Okay, in 1960 the scientists adopted a common set of units for the measurement, common set of standard units for the measurement of different physical quantities. Okay, and that system is called as what? International System of Units, or also it is called as what? SI units. Okay, so that system is called as what? International System of Units, or SI units. And that SI units, or the International System of Units, are used in the different countries or are used in the world wide. Okay, so now let's see the for some physical quantities and their units. Okay, so now let's discuss about the some physical quantities and their units. Okay, so the SI unit of length is what? Meter. If you want to measure the length, then we are using it into the meter. But again it get differentiated, or again it get changes. Means the meter is having, if the length is so small, then we can use into the millimeter or into the centimeter, then we can use also the kilometer. But it means what? The SI unit of length is what? Meter. Okay, it can be shown denoted by the small m. Okay, next one is that the SI unit of time is what? Second. Okay, the SI unit of time is second. It can be shown with the help of the small s. Next one is the SI unit of mass is kilogram or kg. Both are the small letters. Next one is that if you want to measure the temperature, then the SI unit of temperature is what? Kelvin. That is shown with the help of the capital K. Okay, so all these are the different physical quantities and their units. Okay, so the length we can measure in meter, time we can measure in second, mass we can measure in kilogram, and temperature we can measure into the Kelvin. Okay, so this is all the different physical quantities and their standard units. Okay, so this is all about today. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point, and for today, thank you.